been very well made, it fell down and the wolf was able to eat the little pig up in an instant.
What's going on?
You know what's going on? It's the story of the Mongol invasion in the 13th century, you know? We have brother Lech, Czech, Rus, Rus go pick up straw, Mongols come in, blow the house down, take all the shit, yeah? You know, it's all history, it's all history. Okay, keep going, sorry.
Meanwhile, the second and the third pig were still on their way to the brickworks, and when they passed the man with the bundle of sticks, what the fuck is wrong with people? Okay, the second little pig said to himself,
maybe he have witch to burn.
Now I won't need to walk so far to the brickworks. Sticks are stronger than straw. I think they'll do the job, but anyway, I'm tired now. I'd much rather do less work and then spend the rest of my afternoon relaxing. So the first little pig said to the man carrying the sticks, please man, give me some sticks so I can build a house. The man did, and the little pig quickly built a house with it right where he stood, and then settled down and prepared to have a sleep for the rest of the afternoon.
Who the fuck was... Which one was that? Which one of you was that? Little ungrateful shits, I asked this man for 20 minutes to read you birthday story, and what do? You fall asleep? At least have the common fuck human decency to get the fuck out of my server, okay? I can't believe disrespectful gopniks come here like... Oh,
I mean, isn't disrespectful? Who are you calling disrespectful?
You swore on the server! You fall asleep while he's putting in effort!
Wait guys, the wolf is coming.
Oh, suka!
Oh no!
The fucking wolf came and said, Little pig, let me come in.
Oh, you know, after party you say that.
And the pig was like, No, by the hair of my chin. And the wolf was like, then I'll puff and huff and I'll blow your house in. So he huffed and he puffed and he puffed and he huffed and blew the house down and ate a second little pig. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we come to the final third little pig.
User, why you interrupt? I want to hear the third pig. You know how long until my babushka read me this story? Suka, bля, he was 1950, okay? We were a little village near Chelyabinsk. Her last person in the village who knew English, right? She has pre-war book from United Kingdom. Yes, she brought it all the way over here. She read it for everyone in the village. Next year, what happened? She got tuberculosis, died 2 days after in the bed. And you disrespect the story and the memory of my babushka by interrupting like this. I will not stand for it.
I didn't disrespect anyone.
HUNAF, continue, please. I can't. My blood pressure is...
So, basically what happened is the pig built a house out of bricks. And then the wolf came again and then said, Little pig, let me jump. Then the third pig said,
No, by the hair of my chin.
What the fuck is
going
on?
Then the wolf, he was trying to blow the house, could not get it down.
He was trying to blow the house.
I bet he couldn't get it down. You wake up in the morning, you can't get it down. You know, it happens.
And then he found that he could not, with all his huffing and puffing, to blow the house down. He said, little pig, I know where there is a nice field of turnips. And then the pig said,
where?
Oh, in Mr. Smith's home field. And if you will be ready.
What the fuck? Why am I hearing music? Okay.
So...
you interrupted him again, my patience!
So, basically said, go and get some turnips for dinner. And then the pig said,
very well, I will be ready.
What time do you mean to go?
Okay.
Oh, it's around 6 o'clock.
Oh, I like the axe.
And, well, you know, the little pig got up at 5 and got the turnips and was home again before 6. And when the wolf came, he said, little pig, are you ready?
Ready!
Said the little pig.
I've been and come back again and got a nice pot full of dinner.
And the wolf felt very fucking angry at this. But thought that...
he just got scammed.
But yeah, basically, he did. But thought that he would be up to the little pig somehow, so... or other, so he said, little pig, I know where there is a nice apple tree.
Where?
said the pig. Down at the merry garden, replied the wolf. And if you will not deceive me, I will come for you at 5 o'clock tomorrow, and we will go together and get some apples. You know what fucking happened? The little pig woke up at 4 the next morning and bustled up and went for the apples, hoping to get them before the wolf came.
Can't believe he did that.
Scammer pig.
Literal
you know, but he had farther to go and had to climb the tree, so that just as he was coming from down it, he saw the wolf coming, which, as you may suppose, frightened him very much. And when the wolf came up and said,
oh,
little pig, what the fuck? Are you here before me?
You know, wolf reminds me of NKVD agents, you know?
You know, and the pig was like,
yes, worry,
said the little pig.
What? I will throw down one.
And he threw it so far, while the wolf was gone to pick it up, the little pig jumped down and ran home.
Fucking
so the
fact.
Next day, the wolf came again.
Wait, are you
said,
reading the story or are you making it up right now?
No, he's reading it!
So, you know, came the wolf again in the... Wait, where was I?
He was, you said, yes, very, will throw you one, and then he threw it so far, while wolf
okay.
was gone to...
Okay,
yeah,
so,
yeah.
So,
yeah.
Basically, the next day, the wolf came again, I think for the last time, hopefully, and said to the little pig, there is an affair in the town this afternoon.
Oh my god.
Will you go?
No, it's not fan fiction! Fuck the hell of it! I can't believe you look! You don't appreciate art! Just get the fuck out of my face, okay? Fan fiction! Holy shit!
I remember the story differently, like the...
Yeah,
the wolves came to the big house and the people was like, get the fuck out, man. Get the fuck out.
Yeah, but you know, he sent me this story, so I'm reading this story.
Oh, this is I know.
Okay.
Porno script or something, maybe
okay.
at the end.
So, okay. basically, what happened? You know, the next day, Wolf came again and said to the little pig, that there is a fair in the town, and the pig said, like,
oh yes, I will go, and what time shall you be ready?
At 3 o'clock, said the wolf. So the little pig went off before the time as usual, and got to the fair, and bought a butter churn, and was on his way home with it, when he saw the wolf coming. Then he could not tell what to do, so he got into the churn to hide, and in doing so, he turned it round, and it began to roll, and rolled down the hill
oh
with
God.
The pig inside it, which frightened the wolf so much that he ran home without going to the fair.
Oh,
you know,
shit.
You know, basically, the wolf went back to the little pig's house, and told him how frightened he had been by a great round thing which came down the hill past him. And then the little pig said,
I frightened you, did I? I had been to the farm, boat to Butterchun, and when I saw you, I got into it and rolled down the hill.
Man, please don't come to my house. It's fucking stalking. Please leave.
Then the wolf was very angry indeed and declared war on. No, he declared he would eat up the little pig and he would get down the chimney after him. And you know, when the little pig saw what he was about, he hung on a pot full of water and made up a blazing fire. And just as the wolf was coming in down, took off the cover of the pot, and the wolf fell in the pot.
Oh, suka!
Oh my god!
I can't believe
wait,
it.
Wait, it's
getting. What a plot point!
Vanya, cover your ears!
Oh my god!
Sasha, you're old enough! Bongo, shut the fuck up, Bongo. Holy fuck. Degenerate.
Wait,
people
wait,
like
wait,
you belong
wait,
in the. Okay,
wait,
okay! Shh, HUNAF, continue.
It yeah. gets worse. The little fucking pig put on the cover again.
Oh
in
no,
instant,
no, no.
And boiled the wolf.
Oh no!
Wait a second. It's even worse.
No.
And ate the wolf for supper. And then. You know, and then lived happy ever after.
What? He's a fucking carnivore! He murders him with no repercussions. Look, it's law of nature. Wolf want to eat, he just get eaten. What the fuck?
Good night, children.
Oh,
have
so
one.
Oi, spokojnej noci. Oi.
This was fucking morbid.
Yeah, Egan.
Oh my god.
Never again.
This story basically traumatized me.
Yeah, I changed my life forever.
Yeah, my children, I'm not sure if they're asleep or have PTSD, but they're out on the floor.
This story made me horny.
Oh.
You know, my friend, I think you might be a fucking furry.
So, what's wrong with furries?
Either that or degenerate.
I can send you the website so you can check on the illustrations and, you know.
Yes.
Always.
I want to see this wolf get boiled.
No, I sent him
wait,
the website.
I can send it to you, wait. Wait, where is it?
I put it, wait, for anyone who wants it, I put it on voice chat channel. Wait, what the fuck, I can't put it? Okay, that's fine. That sucks.
Wait,
literally just type, oi, suka! Corona!